welcome back to my channel, and welcome if you are new here. I have another WW Instant Pot video coming your way. I have two absolutely indulgent, comfort food, to the max Instant Pot recipes. Incredibly easy to make, both of them, and seriously perfect for this wintry, cold time of year. So if you wanna see what two Instant Pot recipes I have in store for you, just stay tuned. For tonight's Instant Pot dinner, we're gonna be making chicken noodle soup. Comforting, warm, and delicious on a fall or winter day. So cannot wait for this. It's going to be very easy, all in one pot, simple, fast dinner. So let me show you what is in our chicken noodle soup. You're going to need 4 cups of water, 1 box or 4 cups of chicken broth, minced garlic, salt and pepper, thyme and parsley, 4 rather large chicken breasts, celery, carrots, and an onion, and some noodles. So I've had these noodles for a long time. I don't even know where I got these, but I love Fiber Gourmet, and these were sitting in my pantry. So I decided I was going to use them in the soup. I will put here on the screen what I thought of the noodles since I have not tried them yet. So these are the Carbonara Al Dente Egg Fettuccine Noodles. Now these are more points than Fiber Gourmet. And plus, I love Fiber Gourmet, but I thought that I would try these since I had these on hand. So let's get started on our chicken noodle soup. So the first thing that we're gonna do is chop up our veggies. So we have an onion, 2 stalks of celery, and I'll peel and dice up 2 carrots. We're just gonna put these in a bowl because all of these are going to go into the Instant Pot at one time. For our soup is we're gonna go ahead and turn our Instant Pot onto the saute mode. That's gonna get nice and warm. We're gonna go ahead and spray our Instant Pot with some nonstick cooking spray. And I like to spray it pretty good because I wanna make sure nothing sticks to the bottom. Once our Instant Pot warms up, we're gonna go ahead and add in the celery, carrots, and onion mixture. And we're just gonna let those cook down about 4 minutes just until they start to soften. Once your veggies have started to soften a little bit, we're gonna go ahead and add in 2 cloves of our minced garlic. And then the recipe calls for a fresh thyme, but I only have the dried. So I'm gonna go ahead and add about 1 teaspoon of dried thyme. And we're just gonna let this cook just another minute or so, just until the garlic starts to become fragrant. Go ahead and turn your Instant Pot off once everything's become nice and fragrant. To your Instant Pot, you're gonna go ahead and add in your breasts of chicken. I have 4 of them here, and I'm gonna add them in whole. We're gonna actually shred them once it's cooked, so this saves a lot of time by just adding them in whole to your Instant Pot. And then we're going to season them, of course, with some salt and pepper, and go ahead and do that to your liking. It just says season generously with salt and pepper. So a little bit of salt, and then of course we're gonna add in a little bit of pepper. And then the last step before we turn on our Instant Pot and get this cooking is we're gonna go ahead and add in our 4 cups of chicken broth. And I have the Simple Truth Reduced Sodium. I like this chicken broth, it's organic, and the reduced sodium just helps save on that salt intake, especially before weigh-in. So I added the Simple Truth organic chicken broth. And then I'm also going to add in 4 cups of water. So our Instant Pot is going to be nice and full. And then we're ready to go ahead and put on our lid. And we're gonna set this on high manual for 7 minutes. So the timer went off. It has been naturally releasing for about 5 minutes. So I'm gonna go ahead and open up my vent here. As soon as the pressure is gone, we're gonna pop the lid off. Next step is we're going to take out our chicken on the board here, and we're going to shred it up with a couple of forks. So the chicken is out of the Instant Pot. We're just gonna take a couple of forks. It is so tender, you guys. And we're just gonna shred it up. And then we're just literally gonna put the chicken right back into the Instant Pot. So go ahead and get all four chicken breasts nice and shredded up back in the Instant Pot, and then we'll be ready to add in our pasta. So now we're gonna go ahead and add that chicken right back in. Look at this, you guys. Yum, this is a ton of chicken. Be careful not to splash yourself because the liquid is incredibly hot in here. So we're gonna get the chicken added back in, and then it'll be time for some noodles. So here is my dinner for tonight. This is 1/6 of the soup. So this is quite a lot. This is a very large bowl. This looks delicious. I topped it with just a tiny bit of parsley. So for 1/6 or the 6 servings total, it is 5 smart points per serving. I am going to pair mine with some saltine crackers for an additional point. So that will be a 6 smart point dinner. For tonight's Instant Pot dinner, I am making Philly cheesesteak sandwiches. This is going to be delicious, and it is all done in the Instant Pot. So let me show you what is in tonight's dinner. First, you're going to need some hoagie rolls of your choice. I'm going to be using these Private Selection Italian Urban Garlic. These are one of the lower point hoagie rolls that I could find. These are 5 points per roll, and they look delicious. You'll also need some steak. I always just buy the shaved steak. It's just so much easier. It is the perfect consistency, texture, and thickness for Philly cheesesteak sandwiches. I pick mine up at Fred Meyer, which is also a Kroger store. I know Trader Joe's sells it as well. And then you'll need your typical Philly cheesesteak veggies, peppers, and onion. We're also going to need some oregano. I'm gonna be using the Jarlsberg Light Swiss cheese in place of provolone because this cheese is only 1 smart point per slice. I pick mine up at Trader Joe's, but I have heard that Costco carries it as well if you have a Costco or Sam's Club in your area. And lastly, some salt and pepper. So let's get started on tonight's dinner. So the first thing that we need to do is chop. So we are going to chop our 2 peppers into slices, also our medium onion, and then that's it. We're ready to throw everything into the Instant Pot.
Jingle bells ringing in my ear. Jingle bell, a sound that's oh so dear. Frosty the snowman is all around town. Watch out for reindeers are falling down. We stay up waiting for Santa tonight. He climbs down the chimney at the speed of light. While we're dancing around the Christmas tree, hugging and kissing just you and me. Carolers are singing outside our door. Lovely songs we all heard.
So go ahead and pull out your Instant Pot. You're gonna go ahead and turn it on to saute. And then we are going to spray generously our Instant Pot base with some nonstick cooking spray. We're going to let that warm up for just a few minutes, and we're going to add in our veggies. Once your Instant Pot is nice and warmed up, we're going to go ahead and add in all of those veggies. Listen to that sizzle. That is what I like to hear. So we're going to go ahead and all these in. We're going to season them and get them cooked down for about 5 minutes. It won't take very long for them to soften and saute down a bit in the Instant Pot. So we're gonna go ahead and just add some salt. And we are gonna season again once we add in our meat, so you don't have to add a lot of seasoning in the beginning. We're also going to, of course, add a little bit of pepper, because that always makes it taste a little bit better. And then lastly, we're gonna pop in a little bit of oregano. And again, we're gonna let these saute down for about 5 minutes, just until our veggies start to soften. Once your veggies have softened quite a bit, they're still a little bit al dente, but the onions are pretty translucent, which is what we were looking for. We're gonna go ahead and add in our steak. So again, I'm using the shaved steak. If you use any other kind of steak, you would want to probably chop that up first and then go ahead and add it in here with your veggies. I'm going to try to break mine up a little bit. It is very thin slice. Honestly, it is just like you ordered a Philly cheese steak sandwich at a restaurant. It's the perfect steak for this. And then we're gonna just quickly season again. So a little bit more pepper. We wanna make sure there's enough seasoning for both our meat and our veggies. I'm gonna add a little more salt. And then lastly, I'm going to add just a couple more dashes of oregano. Give that another quick mix. We're gonna turn our Instant Pot off of the saute mode. Right now we're on the saute mode. So we're gonna go ahead and turn that off. We are gonna put on our lid and we are going to cook this down for 8 minutes on high. So basically you're just gonna hit manual and you're gonna turn it to 8 minutes and you are good to go. Once the 8 minutes is up, we are going to naturally release for 10 before we remove the rest of the pressure and pop our lid off. So 10 minutes is up on the natural release. So you're just gonna turn your dial. There shouldn't be very much pressure left. So you can see that it's barely releasing any pressure. And then we're gonna go ahead and pop our lid off and I'll show you what our Philly cheesesteak looks like. So pop your lid off and there it is. Oh, that looks so good. So you're gonna wanna give it a stir, make sure your meat is nice and separated. Oh yeah, cooked it through perfectly. So this is kind of what that shaved steak looks like. It's definitely very reminiscent of a restaurant style of Philly cheese. So this looks really good. I'm just going to stir it up a little bit, make sure my meat is shredded and mixed in well with my veggies. And then we are going to put together our sandwiches. I do have some frozen vegetables in the microwave. You can probably hear that in the background that we're just gonna pair with our sandwiches, but this looks really good. So let's put together this dinner and I'll be back to show you my dinner and give you the smart points. Here is my dinner for tonight. I have some veggies with some spray butter, salt, and pepper for zero. And then over here, I have my Philly cheesesteak sandwich. So I have one of the buns, which is 5 smart points. 1/4 of the meat vegetable mixture is also 5 smart points. And then it is 1 point for the slice of the Jarlsberg cheese. So this dinner just for the sandwich is 11 smart points. And then the veggies, of course, are zero. So this is my 11 smart point dinner. Thank you for joining me on another WW Instant Pot video. I hope you enjoyed these two recipes. I'm telling you, they were both absolutely outstanding. My husband and I loved them both. They were definitely that feeling of comfort food for this time of year. All of the recipes are down in the description box below, as well as all of my discount codes, all the links to some of my favorite WW things and things that I consider staples on this program. So definitely check out the description box below. If you're new, welcome to JenswW Journey. I'd love to help have you be part of my YouTube friends and family. So make sure you hit that little subscribe button and that bell just so you're notified whenever I upload. You don't wanna miss a single video. I'd appreciate it if you'd give this one a thumbs up. It really helps my channel. And of course, comment down below and let me know, are you gonna give these recipes a try? They are outstanding, I highly recommend. Thank you guys again so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed another video all about the Instant Pot and WW, and I'll see you next time. Bye guys.